Welcome to another edition of Agency Scaling Secrets, where we talk about the most pressing questions agency owners have all over the world. Today's question that I've gotten is, how can I scale my agency, grow my agency consistently month over month, whether you're at 10,000 to 20, 30, whatever the number is for your agency. Salma, how do I grow that consistently? That is one of the questions I get every single day. Even in our coaching sessions, I talk to agency owners every day. This is one of the common questions. People cannot do this consistently. There's a lot of reasons, and I'm gonna give you exactly what you need to do in your agency to grow that revenue consistently. All right, so let's get started. So I'm gonna give you three things that you need to do to get your revenue consistently growing. So the first one that I see a lot of agencies when they come to me and they have this problem is that they really don't serve a niche. They haven't niched down, if I may, in their business. So they don't have a specific audience that they're trying to serve. They don't have specific type of customers, revenue, size of company, industry, verticals, anything that they can say, like, I help these types of companies, small businesses, maybe it's a company that's doing $10 million or more in the construction space. They cannot articulate, this is my type of customer. And when you have that problem, you become all things to all people. And that's exactly why the revenue looks more like this. Some days lower than you would like to, kind of like the stock market. Instead of that, if you actually focus on who your type of customer you're trying to serve, you can continually market to that audience and become the expert in that space and grow that sales. So this is one of the biggest things that I've seen people having a challenge is the first question I ask, who do you serve? Who's your ideal customer? Who's your avatar? People say that word. And then the answer is, well, it's any business owner. I don't like to narrow it down. I wanna make sure I talk to them first and this and that. Take that information and say, well, show me your revenue for the last 6 months. And it doesn't look anything like this. Clearly, they're not able to articulate who their ideal customers or their ideal customers will never know because they don't look like that's the company they serve. So the customers are not resonating with their message or they're not seen as the expert and they don't seem to be the kind of company that knows exactly what their ideal customer needs. There's just no connection, thus the revenue struggles or suffers. This becomes the biggest burden, I would say, on the revenue is not really knowing who you serve. And we have an entire course, academy, everything around helping agencies grow and scale. So we talk a lot about niche, but this is one area, even for budding agencies, I recommend is really narrow down who you're going after. And you can have a niche within the niche, so you can really niche down. So that's my first recommendation for you if that's what you're looking to do. We figured out the niche. We figured out exactly who we're serving. Let's get to the next topic, right? Like, what do we do? Okay, after that, we updated our marketing message. We have much better funnels and ads and everything running now that we know who we're going after. Your job after that is to really work on the lead gen. So as I mentioned, lead gen becomes the next thing. Can you actually create an offer that resonates with this type of audience? Can you say that, hey, you're the best dental marketing solution because of X, Y, and Z? You're the best construction marketing company. You're the best manufacturing, right? Whatever you're trying to do, right? It doesn't matter what the niche is. They're all equally hard. It doesn't make one niche better than the other. I worked in every single niche you can imagine, from nonprofit to tech SaaS startups, right? So it doesn't make any difference. They all have their own challenges. Lead gen is the same whether you have a niche or you're not. I might as well take the same amount of budget and really make sure that I speak to my ideal audience, drive that traffic to a funnel where they're opting in. Maybe there is a video or a webinar or something that they're attending to create the demand for my products and services, and taking those leads and then further segmenting them to find out which one's ready to buy and which ones may not be a good fit, right? So lead gen becomes the number one thing. So at ClickX, we work with small agencies, mid-sized agencies, large agencies, solutions like this, helping them figure out the niche, coaching them, consulting them, and then driving their own lead gen through Facebook ads and Google ads, retargeting, all those things. So I can tell you confidently, if your revenue is not consistent, your lead generation is not consistent. I can tell you that. This is, again, another area where my third piece is really gonna help you understand why lead gen is the biggest part. Most of the time when agencies are doing all the work that they're getting, they often drop the ball on the lead gen. The more busy you are as an agency, the less likely you're looking at your pipeline, your sales, your inbound, your outbound, whatever it is that you're doing, you're not really looking at sales. You're like, well, I have too much work. I can't worry about sales right now. The last thing we need is another customer and this and that. I mean, these are actual words from consultants that I work with, like, oh, I don't want to focus on that because I really want to make sure. So then their pipeline becomes to get dry and they've gotten past this project. And when they're ready to start closing some deals, they have no appointments, right? They have nothing to worry about. So lead generation becomes, like I said, the biggest hurdle in consistent growth. The more consistent you are in lead generation, the more consistent you are working on that pipeline, whether it's inbound or outbound, there is no one or the other. Successful agents are doing outbound and successful agents are doing inbound. And I have a lot of partners, they do both, right? At the same time, they have solutions to drive consistent connections on LinkedIn and outreach and just referrals, all the things that you can imagine that are driving quality leads. This all to me is under the lead gen. It's not one or the other. So you've gotten the leads, you've figured out the niche, your ideal customer profile. I'm gonna give you the third piece of advice that you can use to consistently grow. And this is kind of what we lead our agencies through this process, which is to have a partner that is helping you from a fulfillment perspective. In that case, it could be any kind of partner. It could be a white label partner like us that's doing the fulfillment services. Maybe they're doing part of the work. Maybe you're doing some of the work. But the reason I say have a third party help you from the fulfillment perspective is to piggyback on my second point of not being so busy that you don't have time to work on your own sales, right? So having someone else deal with the fulfillment, like at ClickX, we even help with client communication and account management, creating reports, having a white label dashboard, and all these things are there to help remove the partner from having to deal with all that campaign management and focus their attention on doing more sales activities. If they're working on more sales activities, guaranteed they're gonna get sales, right? If you're talking to 10 prospects every single day, it's a numbers game. You're going to have some sales at the end of the week or at the end of the day or whatever it is, at the end of the month, you're going to have sales. There's no doubt. But the challenge is, how do you manage the sales activities and the fulfillment and the business management and the payroll and everything else? Therefore, agencies struggle and their revenue is not consistent. It's more down than it is up. It's feast or famine. That's what I hear. All these creative folks that cannot break a $10,000 mark. Maybe you've been in business for several years, but your best month was 20,000. I've talked to consultants, there's nothing wrong with that. It's just that they don't have their systems down where they have a consistent sales pipeline that they can guarantee will have predictable income, right? They don't have the ability to do that. Their funnels aren't scalable. They haven't created anything to create the demand, like the systems to create the demand, the funnels and landing pages, the Facebook ads or anything of that sort, or they don't have a way to capture that by having salespeople or consultants really creating solutions and proposals and so on. And this is your number one key: partnership with the right team, the right people that have done this before. They're not just doing fulfillment work because, you know, you told them to do XYZ. They're like, yeah, sure, I can do XYZ, but they're not really thinking. They're not applying the knowledge. They're not using industry, maybe custom solutions based on past experience, right? Case studies and all the things that we bring to the table is because we've done this type of campaign before. We serve this type of customers. We've done e-commerce. We've done lead gen. We've done any of those things. If you think about it, LinkedIn ads. And if the person that you're working with having done that and they're learning on their first time, you're not gonna be able to scale because you're doing a lot of management. So really figuring out your fulfillment being the biggest thing. And once that's nailed, who is the team that you're gonna be working with to help you with the client fulfillment? Because that's gonna fluctuate. Remember that. That work is going to fluctuate. So figuring that out, and that's consistent, then working on scaling your lead gen to that specific niche and knowing who is it that you are, right? As a company, your identity, and who do you serve? Like, what is it that I am and what do I want to become? How do I help this type of customer get better results? That becomes so critical in getting to that next level in your agency. And once you have that, trust me, 10,000, 20, 30, 50, 80, all looks like a joke, right? At that point, you really know that you've built a scalable business that you can hire people, teach them the process, the product, the ability to sell them and service them, and you have partners that are delivering top quality work, you're able to use that to fundamentally change where you are as a business owner. I really believe that building a business is always better as a partner, as a partnership, rather than doing it as a solopreneur with a few employees or contractors, because at the end of the day, you're only as good as the ideas that you can bring to the table. You can't piggyback on someone who has been doing this for 10 or 15, 30, 40 years maybe. And so having that, their infrastructure become my infrastructure is a game changer in a professional services business, right? In a professional services business, you are only as good as your capacity, as the amount of hours that you have or the amount of hours that your contractors, your employees, your part-time people, whatever you want to call them, that is it. After that, you're capped. That means that your revenue is capped. So unless you fundamentally change the ability to do more work, you cannot touch that revenue line. You cannot even go to 35K because you just don't have the resources to fulfill should you get the business. That's why I say working on a partnership model enables you to scale infinitely in a small business environment than trying to do it all on your own. So when I talk to agency owners, especially new ones, I'm like, hey, here's the path to success. You don't want to be another agency doing the exact same thing other agencies do. Doing the same thing that everybody else is doing to expect different results, you're not gonna get that. Your numbers are gonna look like this, if not worse. And also being someone for a type of company is really, really critical in today's day and age. Everybody's a marketing consultant. So you wanna make sure, hey, I help these types of companies is very critical for your success. So niching down, working on your lead gen and the funnel so that you have unlimited amount of leads that you have no time on the calendar to talk to anybody else, because guess what? I have prospects that are lining up to talk to me. And you know, if you do that, you're gonna grow. And finally, building a partnership where others are helping you scale the organization would be a dream for any entrepreneurs, because what happens in most agency space is that you are working in the business and you're not working on the business. Most of the time when you have a lot of work, they're like, oh, I have to do $15,000 worth of work this month. That means that next month, I may not have any work because I was not working on sales. That's the reality for so many people. They just get so inundated with the day-to-day. The customers are calling, emailing, and you're working in the business 8 hours or 18 hours a day, not really working on the business, which is the systems, the marketing messages, the funnels, the ability to have more leads and hiring people to do more of sales activities. That's what you fundamentally need if revenue growth is your number one thing. So thanks a lot for watching. Our job here at ClickX is simple. We help agencies grow and scale. That's all we do, that's all we've ever done. The way we do that is by providing a platform, the technology, the tools, the training, the track record of success that you can use to grow and scale your agency. So if you have questions on how do you grow consistently, you've come to the right place, right? You can ask us anything. We have coaching specifically catered to small agencies, mid, even higher end agencies. And we've been there, we know exactly what it takes to go and scale, not just the agency, the product and the process, but also the people side of things as a company. So thanks a lot for watching. If you have more questions, leave it in the comment. Tell me your thoughts, if you agree with me, if this simplistic version of growing and scaling an agency makes sense to you. If you have questions or are struggling in any of this area, we'll love to have a conversation. If you like this video, click that thumbs up. And I will see you next time.